Welcome to Pro Hockey Super Bloopers, where you're about to see the goofiest things to ever happen on ice. The fast-paced, frenzied action of hockey can be violent, but there's always something happening to keep the fan on the edge of his seat. Grab your seat right now and stay tuned for some crazy hockey super bloopers.
Blankets on the floor. Turn my pillow upside down. I never did before. Because I was tossing and turning, turning and tossing, tossing and turning all night. Jumped out of bed, turned on the light. I pulled down the shade, went to the kitchen for a bite. Rolled up the shade, turned off the light. I jumped back into bed, it was the middle of the night. The clock downstairs was striking four. Couldn't get you off my mind. I heard the milkman at the door. Cause I was tossing and turning, turning and tossing, tossing and turning all night. Into bed, it was the middle of the night. The clock downstairs was striking four. I couldn't get you off my mind. I heard the milkman at the door. Because I was tossing and turning, yeah, turning, tossing and turning. Day, 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 I was a tossing.
No sport has wilder bloopers than hockey. Sticks fly, and so do players. Glass breaks. Sticks stick. Players crash. Pucks fly. Even referees get into the act. Bloopers and hockey just go together.
Thank you. shot. That's a score. The lights on.
Dave Maloney.
Oh, boy.
Dave Maloney hit Larmer.
There goes the bench.
The benches are emptying now. It's a bench emptying brawl. The first one I've seen in a long time.
I think Dave Maloney is really hurt.
I think he got hit hard. O'Callaghan went after him, creamed him before he could really get set, and someplace under that mess.
Dave Maloney bumped Larmer after Larmer deflected the puck in the net. O'Callaghan, in a very, very backstabbing type of a play,
did he ever
really nailed David Maloney.
Well, I'll tell you what happened.
Trying to haul somebody off.
Somebody is hurt.
What they got to do is open everything up there.
I'll tell you what, something like this, if we see on the replay, O'Callaghan should get a suspension you wouldn't believe for something
That's
like
right.
this.
I don't understand him doing that.
And I was.
He got cross-checked real
I'll
bad.
Tell you what, folks.
Ronnie Greschner is just livid.
Dave Maloney's up on his feet, as we can see here. He obviously has a cut above the eye. Thank God he looks like he's all right. I'll tell you, I hope we get a replay of this. He bumped Larmer after Larmer scored. Nothing dirty, and O'Callaghan
Somebody's
came in from
the
blue
on the
line.
Ice for the Blackhawks.
One of the Blackhawks is also hurt and down on the ice.
That's O'Callaghan.
Well, that's just a fight they just broke
he's
up.
He's not hurt.
He's been going on there all and the Rangers want
look
him.
Look at Beck. Oh, does Beck want O'Callaghan? And Greschner, look at Ronnie Greschner.
He's got that back. I wish he'd get out of there.
That's one of the worst backstabbing plays I've seen in my 11 years in the National Hockey League.
But the fact remains, John, these guys ought to knock it off, every single one of them. It's stupid.
Now they're putting O'Callaghan down there with Dave Maloney. They better not. Because I know Dave Maloney.
There are hockey players who are good, and then there are hockey players who are bad, and some are very bad. That's why we have officials. The men in the striped shirts keep the peace and keep the game flowing. Well, most of the time.
first time I saw you, girl, I knew that I just had to make you mine. But it's so hard to talk to you with fellas hanging around you all the time. I want you for my sweet pet, but you keep playing hard to get, going around in circles all the time. Dizzy, I'm so dizzy, my head is spinning like a whirlpool, it never ends. And it's you, girl, making it spin.
Make the game fun, and they have fun doing it. Of course, everyone doesn't always keep their cool during the action, while some are in it for the kicks. For every action, there's an equal reaction. I think it was Einstein who said that. Either Einstein or else Scotty Bowman. Thank you.
was aiming at a 4-inch slot 120 feet away. The insurance company underwriting the $100,000 prize figured chances of a non-athlete making it at more than 100 to 1. And 46-year-old Bruce Hanna, by his own admission, is no athlete. Something must have happened before his second shot. It was his last chance. He made a few adjustments in his form and then performed a feat Wayne Gretzky and Dino Cicerelli can only dream about. Bruce turns modest when you ask him about it. There wasn't any goalie out in front, he says. Still, it makes him wonder whether he could ever have made it on the ice.
Contact is a part of hockey. You've got to be a bruiser to play pro hockey. You've got to take it and dish it out with equal assertiveness. It's all part of the territory of being a hockey player. But that doesn't mean you have to like it.
Said goodbye. Is that a shame? My tears feel like rain. Is that a shame? You the one to blame. You broke my heart when you said we'll part. Is that a shame? Chills feel like rain. Ain't that a shame? You're the one to blame. Oh, well, goodbye. Although I'll cry. Ain't that a shame? My chills feel like rain. Said goodbye. Ain't that a shame? My tears feel like rain. Ain't that a shame? You're the one to blame. Oh, well, goodbye. Although I'll cry. Ain't that a shame? Chill feel like rain. Ain't that a shame? You're the one to blame.
Some crazy people at a hockey game, on and off the ice. Most fans are calm. But then there's Morgana, the kissing bandit, who brings her own style to the game. Crazy coaches, zany mascots, you get the idea.
juicy. Hey, how about a nice Hawaiian punch?
Sure.
You taste 7 kinds of fruit in Hawaiian punch. 7 kinds of fruit in Hawaiian punch. Hawaiian punch is made with 7 kinds of fruit for a one-of-a-kind fruit taste.
Hawaiian Punch Fruit Punch with 10% real fruit juice for a real fruit juicy taste.
Hawaiian Punch is made with 7 kinds of fruit
for a one-of-a-kind fruit taste.
Fighting in hockey is as American as apple pie, as Canadian as the maple leaf, and happens about as often as a New York traffic jam. Otherwise calm people just seem to lose their cool when they lace up their skates. The brawling is always a fan favorite, even if some fans are a bit reluctant to admit it.
Okay, that's 2 Big Macs, 2 fries, and 2 Cokes.
Hey, what'd you get me?
I got you a couple of Big Macs and some fries.
Gee, thanks a lot, pal.
Hey, no problem.
Good evening, sports fans, and welcome to another wonderful night of boxing. Buy Pap Schmear Blue Ribbon Beer, the beer with the clinical taste. And tonight, we have a wonderful fight for you right here above us at the Little Nick Arena here in New York City. And the challenger, as he makes his way into the ring, weighing in at 172 pounds, is Jacques Le Doudou. He looks cool, he looks confident, he looks carefree, and he wants to take on the champion of the world this evening. There should be no problem with this bout. It's a scheduled 10-rounder, and boy am I good. Okay, we're gonna go up to the ring announcer, but we're having trouble with the audio. So, I'll tell you right now, it's Jacques Le Doudou against the world heavyweight champion of the world, weighing in at 202 pounds. Boy, he's a big boy tonight. The one, the only, Brian LaBeouf. Let's hear it, everyone, for Brian, the champion who's got the hardest punch in the world. He looks very, very confident this evening. Knows what he's about to do is going to be very dangerous, but he'll try. The referee steps in between them, gives them the rules, the normal rules here. It's an 8-count knockdown and no hitting below the belt. bent, no squeezing of the nipples, and no pulling of the chest hairs. That's the rules that we're going to go by tonight, and by God, we will follow them. Okay, I can hardly wait till it begins. The fighters are going into their corners right now, and it looks like we're going to see one of the greatest fights of all time right here. You've seen it before. There's the bell. And here they come. Boy, he looks like he's going. Oh, LeBeau has got him. LeDoudou is down. And right there, folks, he's got him. He's down. He's out. It looks like he's not going to be able to return. The doctor's working on him now. No way. It's over. It's done. He's lost the fight. And Brian LeBeouf, the world champion and still heavyweight champion of the world.